The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Right this way, folks. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Step right up. Yes, welcome this night to a carnival. To the razzle-dazzle clash of color and sound. Hiding hate and evil and murder.
Right this way, the freak show, ladies and gentlemen. See nature's mistakes. Step right up.
It's opening night at Prince's Carnival outside St. Louis. But no fortune teller sees in cards or crystal ball the dark events that will happen here.
I loathe everything you are. The sight of you sickens me. I'll...
You're what? Beat me? Break me?
Yes!
Try it. Every man in the carny knows you're here, knows what you are. Giant, strong man, grips, barkers, they're all standing by. If I call, they'll tear you apart. Oh, give me reason to call. I'd love it. Go on. Hit.
Our suspense drama, Tattooed for Murder, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Nancy Moore and stars Teri Keane and Stefan Schnabel. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. I promised you a carnival. I'll keep that promise. But be warned that I do not promise a spun sugar candy time. On the contrary, first we must go back 3 years. That summer, St. Louis papers carried a story that was milked for all it was worth. It was worth a great deal. Headlines.
Otto Kramer's daughter missing. Heiress disappears. Erica Kramer not found. Foul play suspected.
That was 3 years ago. Today, a mansion outside the city has a bronze plaque fixed to iron gates. Otto Kramer, no admittance. Due perhaps to the disappearance of a daughter of this house, no one is welcomed beyond its gates. Inside alone on this fateful morning, another daughter, Katrin, age 16, a few minutes ago said goodbye to her father as he left for his bank. She now starts upstairs to clean. In spite of his wealth, Kramer keeps no servants, obeying his own dictate, no admittance. Suddenly, Katrin is startled by a frightening sound. Only the doorbell. But no one comes here unless her father is present, and seldom then. Would Papa want her to answer? Katrin thinks not, is certain not. The ringing persists. But suddenly the sound no longer seems frightening. Instead, a merry summons, the world at her door. She flies down the stairs, but as her hand turns the doorknob, hope vanishes. No one has come to see her. No one ever will. Papa forbids it. Papa's word is law, is iron.
Katrin. Oh, don't you know me, Kate? Erica.
Oh, little sister. I can't believe it. I thought you were dead.
No, I'm real. I'm here. I'm back, and I'm certainly not dead.
Oh, I've dreamed of this 1,000 times.
Oh, so have I, little Kate. Dreamed and planned. But come inside. Hurry. I don't want to be seen.
Does that mean you'll go away again? Oh, Erica, don't. Please don't.
We'll talk about that in a minute. First, I have to look at this house.
Oh,
This prison I broke out of. Nothing's changed. Cold and ugly. No, I don't want to look at it. Let me look at my little Kate.
Erica, where have you been?
Oh, you are so pretty now. You're sweet, sweet 16.
Doesn't matter about me. Tell me where you've been all these 3 years.
You matter more than anything. Oh, does Papa ever let you out of this house?
Well, sometimes he takes me driving, and sometimes to church.
Papa, in church? And the rest of the time, what do you do?
Have you forgotten what it's like here?
Oh, Kate, how could I? But then there were two of us. We could at least talk to each other. Who do you talk to now?
No one.
No tutor anymore?
Not since I was 16.
Not one single friend? No fun at all? Never mind. I know the answer. And Papa's made you into this pitiful little mouse.
Oh, please don't talk about me anymore. Tell me where you went.
Guess.
Oh, but we did guess. Papa and I and the police. Oh, and the smartest private detective in all of St. Louis.
All that money squandered for nothing.
Where were you? Why won't you tell me?
All right, little one. Hang on tight. I was in the last place on earth Papa would dream a daughter of his could be.
Where?
In a carnival.
You're teasing. It's a joke.
Yes, a beautiful, wonderful joke. But the joke's on Papa. A Kramer daughter, part of a carny. Remember the summer I disappeared, the carnival 2 miles away?
Uh-huh.
Remember how we could hear the music sometimes?
Oh, yes, I do remember. You said it was a merry-go-round.
One afternoon, I sneaked off to see it. I couldn't tell you, honey. I was 19 and grown, but you were only 13. It would have scared you. Papa would know it. He would sense it, and he'd pry the story out of you.
No.
Yes, baby.
All right. Well, maybe then. But not now. Not anymore.
So, after I saw everything at the carny, bold as brass, I went to see the owner, Jody Prince. I told him about this concentration camp. I said I wanted to be in his carnival. He liked my looks. He said he could use me in one of his shows, and he'd sign me on. The next week, when Prince's carnival left St. Louis, I left with it. Out of this house of death, into a carnival that was life.
My sister in a carnival? What do you do in a place like that?
You'll know soon enough. Now, come on. Let's pack your bag. I'm taking you with me, and you'll never come back to this jail again.
Taking me? Never come... Me?
Why else would I be here? Take this chance. Baby, did you think I'd forgotten you?
But you never wrote. You never phoned.
Katie, you must have known I didn't dare. Papa would have all mail forwarded to the bank, have the phone tapped, or what friends did we have to send a message by? I had to wait till the carny came back to St. Louis. But all these years I have planned for this day. The day Papa would lose you, too. So come on, let's pack your bag.
I can't go. I can't do that.
Kate, please don't be afraid. You'll be as safe in the carny as I've been. He won't look for you there any more than he looked for me. Anyway, you will stay out of sight until we leave town.
No, you don't understand. I have to take care of Papa. He's getting old. He has a very bad heart condition.
Kate, you have given him 16 years of your life, and what has he given you? He's locked you in this prison, made you a servant, beat you.
He hasn't beaten me once since you went away.
I don't believe that.
It's true, never.
Well, then you never crossed him. I did. Mama did. And we both paid for it, Kate. Mama died of it. I ran away from it. And you're so beaten down, he doesn't even need to use that walking stick.
Papa and I get along. Maybe not like other people, but we've made a life. The only life I know. Why did you have to come and bring another? Go away so I can forget you ever came.
All right, Katie.
Please.
Katie, please. Look, this is too sudden. This is too new. Papa owns you, owns every thought. You need time for thoughts of your own. Now, I'll go away. Until tomorrow. Today and tonight, think about the carny with me. I will go everywhere, see everything. It's like merry-go-round music, honey. Think of it like that.
A merry-go-round?
Mm-hmm. And you won't tell Papa I was here.
Oh, Oh, no.
Katie, promise.
Nothing in the whole world could make me tell him.
Tomorrow morning I'll come again. And by then you'll change your mind. Tomorrow my little sister and I will go back to the Carney together.
Papa? Would you like some more meat?
No.
Wasn't the roast the way you like it? Papa? Will you have anything else at all?
No.
Then, if it's all right with you, I'll do the dishes. Excuse me.
Daughter!
Oh.
Sit down. You have not my permission to leave.
Yes, sir.
You will answer a question, Katrin, and you will answer with care. What is wrong with you tonight?
Nothing's wrong, Papa.
Nothing is wrong. I see. Or do you think perhaps you can fool your father?
Well,
yes, Katrin?
Please, I'm not trying to fool you.
There is a difference here. Something has happened. Now you will inform me what it is.
What could possibly happen?
That is what I intend to learn. Did you leave this house?
No, sir.
Someone was here?
No, sir.
You lie.
No, Papa, no.
Then why did your hands tremble when you passed my food? Why is your face flushed like an apple? Why?
I just don't feel very well. All day I...
All day you hide something. Tonight you lie. I will have the truth, Katrin. One way or another, I will have it.
I did tell you a lie, Papa. I went out.
Ah. Out where, my child?
To the grocery store.
And how did you go to the grocery store?
The bus.
And what did you want at the store?
To buy apples.
I do not see any apples.
Oh, but they didn't have any.
A pity. Since you so much wanted apples that you left the house, you are not allowed to leave. But we are very fond of apples. Are we not, Katrin?
Yes, Papa.
Why can't you look at me, Katrin?
I am, Papa.
Yes, now you are. Now, why do you stammer, huh, little one? Your pleasant outing today has made you nervous, yes? Answer me!
Papa!
Answer, what ails you?
I told you, I don't feel good.
Oh, your health is poor. I had forgotten. You will forgive me my lapse of memory.
I'll go up and lie down if you don't need me anymore.
No, I cannot spare you. There's something I want you to get for me. My walking stick.
But it's there by your chair, Papa.
Yes, so it is, yes. But it is my whim that you hand it to me. All right, walk around the table. Pick it up. Place it in my hand. Come on! Good. I put great store by obedience. You know that, do you not, Katrin?
Yes, sir. Your stick, Papa.
On second thought, you will hold it yourself. And we will observe it. The gold carving on the top. Describe it, please.
It's a crown.
A crown signifying authority. My walking stick once belonged to the Emperor Napoleon. His hand held it. Now yours, soon mine. One more question, child. Why do I always carry it?
I don't know.
As the symbol of my authority. And when that authority is questioned, is in doubt, the walking stick of Napoleon removes that doubt. You follow me?
Yes, sir.
Alas, your sister's disobedience in the past compelled me to use it. But not on you, never. And I trust I never will. Shall we test you?
I don't know what you mean, Papa.
I think you do. Who was here today, my little Katrine?
No one, Papa. No one was here. Only me all day, except when I went for the apples. No one.
All right. Hand me the stick. Thank you. A fine instrument for changing lies to truth. Soon it will persuade you to talk and not about apples. Who was here today? Now, will you answer?
Yes.
Ah, friend, explain it. Who was here with my little girl? Who?
Erica!
One hour later, Otto Kramer stalks down the thronging chaos of the carnival midway. Fury mounts to the bursting point as again and again he asks the same question. Where is Erica Kramer? And receives the same answer. Never heard of no Erica Kramer, mister. Carney personnel banded together to protect one of their own.
Step right up, folks. Right this way.
Right what way? Where in this pigsty is his daughter? We'll find out when I return shortly with Act Two. Kramer glares with revulsion at the freak tent barker ballying the treasures within.
See them all, folks. 25 cents. Only 2 bits. 1/4 of a dollar.
Kramer looks above the ballet stand at the garish canvases picturing the freaks. Larger than life. More terrible than life. His eyes rivet on the painting of a nearly naked woman. Her body ornamented with hearts, flags, stars, flowers, sunsets, peacocks, snakes. Then, lips locked white, he buys a ticket and enters the tent. On the fifth platform stands the tattooed princess, her body debauched by the colored needle, her beautiful face unmarred, smiling at her admirers. Kramer halts by the first platform, stares. And when he has seen enough of his daughter's depravity, he turns and quits the tent.
Erica. Princess. He's coming.
I'm ready. Stay back of my wagon, Jody. Stay out of sight.
I ought to be in here with you. Your father's got a heavy walking stick.
Of course he has. He always has. Go on, Jody. I'm not afraid of him anymore. I can take care of Papa.
All right. Holler if you need me, sweetheart.
I will. Go on. Oh, hurry, Papa. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Show about to begin. Oh, and how I'll relish it. I let the midget tell you where my living wagon is. If I hadn't, no one in the carny would give me away. You think I didn't see you in the freak top? And the look on your face when you saw my body? Now it's covered with a cape. To spare you, Papa? Oh, no. To play a game. And my game will outsmart yours, Papa. Hurry up. The stakes are high. Oh, hurry, damn you. Greetings, Papa.
Ah, freak! My daughter, a freak!
Would you care to come in? Or would a carnival living wagon contaminate the distinguished Otto Kramer?
I will come.
The Princess Frederica is highly honored.
Princess Frederica.
Aren't you pleased I didn't use the name you gave me?
I am revolted by everything you are.
Oh, dear, I'm so sorry.
And so sorry. You beat poor little Kate till she told you where I was.
That is a lie. Katrine tells me everything. She is my good, obedient daughter, not like you. Katrine has no sister. Her sister is dead.
Dead? Oh, no, old man, you're wrong. You who think you're never wrong. Katrine's sister is wonderfully alive. Making up for the years I might as well have been dead. 19 years you kept me buried alive.
I came here to take you back where you belong. But you belong where you are, with the dregs of humanity. I wouldn't have this thing you are now. A freak flaunting the corruption of your body for anyone to see.
Well, how well you put it. Would you care to have a private viewing? Oh, of course you would. Very well, Mr. Kramer. I remove my cape.
Oh, freak! Tattooed freak!
Can you think of a better way to disguise the scars my father put on my body? A snake, a rose, the stars and stripes cover stripes. You gave me. Oh, yes. I read the description you supplied the newspapers of your missing daughter. Scars on back from automobile accident. What accident? Oh, God, how I wanted to write to the editor. Dear sir, you cheat my distinguished father. You underrate his powers. The scars on Erica Kramer's back are from his loving hand. Papa, why can't you stop staring at me? Hearts and twine, garlands of flowers, Cupid smirking. How strange you find them beautiful.
No, they are loathsome. Vile!
You'll what? Beat me? Break me?
Yes!
I wouldn't raise that walking stick if I were you. Everyone in the Carney knows you're here, knows what you are, and they are standing by. If I call, they'll tear you apart. Go on. Hit! Give me reason to call. They'll come, every man on the lot. Big Lou, the giant, Herman, the strong man, the grips, the concessionaires, and the man I'm going to marry.
What kind of man would marry a freak? Lie with a woman covered with cartoons? Only another freak.
Jody Prince owns this carnival, and he's like his name. He's a prince. Now get the hell out of here before I have him throw you out.
Ah, with pleasure I go. The sound and sight of you sickens me. You freak.
My body's tattooed, but your soul is. You're the freak.
And you stay away from my Katrine.
That's one order I'll take from you, old man. This morning I thought my sister was worth saving. Well, she's not. She went crying to you about me. Kate's lost. She's all yours. Take her and welcome. Now get out. Ah, oh, you think that's all, Papa? You think I'm through with you? That was only a teaser. The best is yet to come. Jody? Are you out there?
Right here, honey. I just wanted the old man out of sight. If I met him face to face, I might kill him.
Did you hear it all?
Every word. Till you threw him out. I was right here by the door. Beautiful.
Oh, it took me 22 years to win, but I have won, Jody. I have won.
Yes. But there's something I don't understand. You said you were through with Kate.
I lied. I had to. I had to make him think I wouldn't try to see her again. If he thought I'd be back, he'd have Kate guarded and I couldn't get to her tomorrow.
Oh, baby, he's no dummy. He probably knows you lied and why. Anyhow, he won't take a chance. You'll be guarded, all right. Count on it.
Then I'll get to her another way.
How?
I've got it all figured. I'm enough of my father's daughter, so nothing can stop me now. Good morning, Papa.
Erica.
Your secretary is taking her coffee break, so I just walked in. I hope you don't mind.
How dare you come here and shame me? Close that door.
Out of respect for your lofty position in the bank, I wore a high neck and long sleeves. But I will shame you. Unless you give me Kate.
Are you out of your wits?
I tried to phone her. You've cut the wires.
Ah,
telephone is merely out of order. Very unfortunate.
I went to the house. You've hired a thug to keep me out.
A friend, a house guest.
A jailer guarding the gates.
He will protect Katrine from undesirable associations. She suffered that indignity yesterday. It will not happen again.
Unless you give me Kate, I will drag your name through the law courts.
Indeed.
All of St. Louis will know what you are. You think I won't?
I dare say your folly would go to that extreme, yes. But what judge or jury would take the word of a cheap carnival tramp? Your word against Otto Kramer's? Who would believe a freak whose body is a monstrosity?
Oh, they'll believe me when I show them what the pious Otto Kramer did to that body.
Leave this office. Go where you belong. To freak tent.
Okay, Princess, I case the joint.
Can we do it?
Risky, but we can pull it off.
Now? In broad daylight?
When you're afraid your old man will yank Kate out of town or at least hide her somewhere, it's now or never.
How do we do it?
Well, if your house wasn't in the country, we couldn't. Sure, the place is locked and barred, but what we do is get a rope ladder up to Katrine's windowsill.
What about the guard? How do we get through the gate?
I'll take care of him. He's a cinch. He'll stay out of sight while I rap with our friend. I'll be a drunk looking for a shot of booze to cure a hangover.
Oh, Jody.
Listen, it'll be a great act. I'll be falling down drunk, see? I get close to the guy, he's off guard. Whammo, I knock him out. You go up the ladder and persuade Kate to come down it.
Can I persuade her?
Oh, sure you can. You hold all the cards, sweetheart. That plan you've worked out for her is a winner. Come on, let's go.
Me, he'll bring me back.
He'll come, all right, but not bring you back. I promise, honey.
But how can you say that? You know he will.
Because I've got a plan to stop him. Marvelous plan. I fooled him when I joined the carny, and I can again.
No one can fool him. Last night when I tried to lie, he knew. He always knows.
And last night, what did he do to you, Kate?
I don't want to talk about it.
Kate, we have to. Now listen to me.
No, I can't.
He has started and he can't stop. The least thing you do to displease him, he'll use that stick.
No.
And nothing will please him except pain. Yours.
Don't. Please.
That's what you'll say to him. Don't, Papa, don't. And it won't do any good, Katie. Can't you see? You don't dare stay here anymore.
I don't dare go. When you went to the carnival, he didn't know where you were. He couldn't bring you back. With me, he'll know, and he will bring me back.
Little sister, please trust me. I tell you, my plan will work, but we need all day to get ready. Now stop crying. Listen to the plan.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the star of Princess Carnival. Step right up to the platform, step lively. Feast your eyes. Every inch of her lovely body, a work of art. Blazoned with hearts and flags, flowers and cupids, snakes and peacocks, suns and stars. Frederica, the tattooed princess. All right now, quiet, please. Quiet now, quiet. Watch as the princess turns and the glory of
Johnny,
her charm.
Johnny, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Handsome gentleman who honors our little show tonight. Mr. Otto Kramer, isn't it? Why, ladies and gentlemen, I do believe the foremost banker of St. Louis is an admirer of the tattooed princess. Well, move along, all you lovely people. Come back to see me later. Right now, dear Mr. Kramer wants to talk privately to his princess. And bankers always get their money's worth.
Oh, all right, across the tent, ladies and gentlemen. Keeney the midget craves your company. All right, step lively, right this way, right this way.
Good evening, Papa. How generous of you to patronize the freak show a second time.
Where is Katrine?
And how clever of you to know that she's with me.
What have you done with her?
I've taken her out of bondage.
Answer me!
I answered.
I'll ruin you for this. I'll have this carnival blasted off the map.
Just how do you propose to do that, Mr. Kramer?
Now show me a carnival that isn't breaking the law. Underage performers, harboring criminals, white slavery. And now kidnapping.
Katrine left of her own free will.
She is 16, not of age. That is kidnapping.
Oh, dear, dear. I never thought of that. So why haven't you called the police?
What, and humiliate her? Make this vileness public? Now, I call them after I take her away from here tonight. Now, where is she? You think you can keep her from me?
I've no intention of keeping her from you. You can see her at midnight, after the last show.
I'll see her now!
You'll see her when I say you can see her. Midnight, 4 hours from now, right here in this tent. Don't try to find her. She's hidden and protected. Until then, I recommend the House of Horrors. You'll feel right at home.
Earlier this night, when Otto Kramer found his house empty, he stood murmuring Katrin's name over and over. Can it be that, in his twisted way, he does love this daughter? Nevertheless, his fingers tightened on the walking stick. When he left for the carnival, he did not trouble to lock the door. What was valuable in his house already had been stolen. No admittance. Anyone who disobeys Otto Kramer must be punished. We'll witness someone's punishment when I return shortly with Act Three. Midnight. The carnival toys are silent. Closed down. The midway is emptying of customers, departing with bright balloons and cheap prizes won in games of chance. But one customer most surely does not depart. And another game of chance is about to begin. Otto Kramer paces the dimly lighted freak tent, a walking stick gripped in his hand. In Erica's living wagon, his two daughters are no less tense than their father. Both wear long satin capes winking with sequins. Erica's purple, Katrin's red.
You two beautiful dolls ready?
Oh, Jody, will it work?
Easy, princess, easy. It'll work.
It can't. Oh, I never should have come.
Oh, now quit it, both of you.
If Papa takes Kate back...
It'll be worse than it was before.
Will you cut it out?
All those promises I made her, what was I thinking of?
You know, I never saw you like this before. My girl has a nerve of 10 people, ain't scared of nothing.
That's when I take chances for myself. This is for Kate. Maybe I'll hurt her instead of help.
And maybe you'll give her the world by the tail.
Erica, why didn't you ask the fortune teller if we should do this?
Oh, for Pete's sake. Carlotta can't even predict that the sun will rise.
And we can't predict Papa.
Oh, I wish I hadn't come.
Now, you won't say that when it's all over, honey.
Like spinning the wheel of fortune. Will it stop on Kate's number? The odds are terrible against her, Jody.
I'll give you big odds. One gets you 20, the wheel spins her number.
It won't. I know it won't.
Oh, now, damn it. We spent all day getting ready for this caper. Here it is, time for the big performance. You're both a mess. All right, you want to call it off? Let your old man win hands down? Is that what you want?
No. No, never. Just the sound of the words makes me sick. Thank you for saying them. Put my head back together. All right, Kate. I promise you, all over again, Papa won't want you anymore. He won't take you back. Now, believe it.
I will. I have to. Now, can we please just get it over with?
That's more like it. All right, you're set, Kate. Remember everything you're supposed to do and say now.
Every single thing we rehearsed. If I can just go through with it.
My money's on you, kid. You're your sister's sister.
Oh, I hope I can remember the part about the wings. I like that part.
Let's just run over a couple of things. Princess, when you go into that tent alone, you keep the old man standing right by the entrance. Don't let him too near Kate, huh?
I know.
If he moves toward her, step in between if you have to.
Don't worry.
Kate waits about 2 minutes, then makes her entrance.
Oh, it'll be the longest 2 minutes in the world.
Well, that's why you wait till I say when. I don't want you jumping the gun. And remember, you're the one that stays close to the entrance.
I will.
And all the time, I'll be right outside.
Ready or not, Papa, here we come.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. Show about to begin. Hey, and what a show.
sorry I kept you waiting, Papa.
Where is Katrine?
She'll be along.
Now, what new trick is this now?
Such a suspicious mind, Papa.
Now, you kept me here cooling my heels while you had her spirited away. But it will do you no good. You will be arrested for kidnapping and forced by the police to tell me where Katrine is.
Simmer down, Papa. None of that will be necessary. Kate is just primping a little. She wants to be pretty for you.
Hello, Papa.
Ah, Katrine. You will come home with me this minute. And take off that cape.
But such a pretty cape, Papa. Red satin and sequins.
Oh, your sister's cheap finery. Take it off at once.
Dear Papa, you sound like a customer at a burlesque show. But I warn you, if Kate takes off the cape, you may not like what you see. She's wearing what I wear in my act. A G-string.
Oh, Katrine, you would not.
You don't believe it, Papa?
No.
Well, then I'll have to show you. I'll spread my cape like wings. Wings for flying. Free as a bird. And you can see if I'm as pretty as Erica. There. Look.
Oh, my God.
Take a good look, Papa.
Katrine.
Yes.
Not you.
Yes, Katrine tattooed like me.
Tattooed all.
No.
Who tattooed daughters? What a proud father.
Aren't the roses and sunsets pretty? The flags and the hearts.
Put down that cane.
I'll break her in two for this.
Get out. Go to my wagon. I'll finish with Papa.
I'm sorry you don't like it, Papa.
Jody, go with Kate.
Oh, you.
Put down the cane. You won't break me in two either. Kate and I have broken you.
Oh, Katrine.
Katrine tattooed. Katrine as repulsive as you find me. Can you ever bear to look at her again?
No.
Since you don't want her anymore, then she can live with me.
Oh. So that is your game. I see now. I see. Want her? No.
So go home to your empty house, and I wish you joy in it.
I do not want her, but I will have her.
What?
I will have my daughter.
You'll take her back the way she is now.
I will take her, and the rest of her life, she will be locked away. She's a freak. And freaks should be hidden from the world.
You can't.
A freak? That is what you have made of your sister. Made ugly what was beautiful. I hope that you are satisfied. That you are set.
Papa! Papa?
Medicine. Pocket.
Your heart. Kate said you had a heart condition.
Pocket, medicine.
Oh, it's a bad attack, isn't it, Papa? That's very bad.
Erica,
what a shame, because I didn't quite understand what you were saying before you fell down in the sawdust like that. I think you were saying you hope I'm satisfied.
Please.
Oh, Papa, I'm satisfied. I'm very satisfied. That medicine in your pocket... You have to take that to live, don't you?
Jody, stay outside. I'm coming out. You stay there.
Oh, and Papa, you stay there. As if you could do anything else. I'll be back. Don't you worry. I'll be back.
You all right, Princess?
Oh, yes. Yes, Jody. You go back to Kate. You go back.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing's the matter. I'm saying goodbye to Papa, that's all. Go on, Jody. Katie needs you. I don't.
I don't like the way you sound.
You think this is easy? The hardest thing I ever did in my life, but I have to do it alone. Now, will you go?
All right, I'll go.
Can I do it? Can I? Papa?
Erica, medicine.
Yes, I understand. You needed to live.
Yes, yes.
Oh, yes, Papa, I understand that, too. But I don't know that, do I? Nobody ever told me. Oh, Papa, did you ever let Kate and me live? Did you ever give us what we needed? Now, hear this, Papa. If you still have time to wonder how I can do what I will do, I learned it from you, Papa. How could I possibly live with viciousness and evil and hate for 19 years and not have some of it come off on me?
Medicine! Hurry!
Yes, I'll hurry and tell Katie you're letting her stay. With your blessing. It is your blessing. Because you have to die so Kate can live. Goodbye, Papa. Goodbye, Papa.
Erica. Country.
Tell me again. Say it again. Papa doesn't want me.
He doesn't want
you.
Oh,
he won't take me away.
No, he won't take you away, now or ever.
He doesn't want me all tattooed.
He doesn't want you.
And you're sure he's gone?
Yes. He is gone.
Poor Papa. He didn't like my sunsets and flags and roses and hearts.
Or truth, or decency, or kindness.
Erica, what's the matter with you? You don't sound a bit happy.
I am. I am, of course I am, little Kate. It's just that I don't like sunsets and flags and roses either. Not on you. Come on, let's wash all those pictures off.
Oh, what if Papa had come close to me? What if he'd seen they were only painted on?
How could he, Kate? All his life, Papa never saw anything but evil and ugliness. Come on, Katie. Soap, water, a scrub brush, and my little sister is as good as new.
By now, you know it is not my custom to point a moral. But allow me, just this once. Thank you. The moral is this. Erica spoke a profound truth. You cannot live with viciousness and evil and hate and not have some of it come off on you. I'll be back shortly. My friends, you allowed me to draw a moral from our experience tonight. A rather depressing moral, I'm afraid. So let's look at the other side of the coin, the bright side. If you live with the good, the true, and the beautiful, some of that will come off on you, too. Our cast included Teri Keane, Stefan Schnabel, Rosemary Rice, and Ralph Bell. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Not there! For God's sake, Charles! Why not? That's the haunted villa.
You superstitious?
About that place. Anyway, it's boarded up. Has been for years.
Well, there's the house now. Maybe we can find some shelter. Oh! Statue! There is the house. The lightning hit it.
I can't look. It's as bright as molten steel.
It's gone. Melted as it had never been.
I could swear I saw that thing jump and run into the house.
The whole villa is lighting up.
Maybe it's on fire.
Don't be silly. It's lamplight. And look, the door has opened.
Welcome, strangers. Come. This is no night to be abroad. Welcome to the Villa di Despair. The House of Despair.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Sinoff, the sinus medicines. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.